Imagine that! Jeff Hardy's been arrested again. This time in South Carolina for alleged public intoxication. Imagine my lack of complete and total surprise. Same thing, I'm sure, goes for a lot of you. And look, I've always been a fan of Jeff Hardy. And yes, deep down, I root for people to overcome their demons and come out better for it on the other side and be able to make positive impacts on other people. And clearly, Jeff Hardy still has demons to battle. And clearly is not battling them very successfully. So let it not be said that I'm rooting against it. Let it not be said that I don't care that he gets over this. Let it not be said that I don't want him to get the help, that I don't think he needs the help, or that he shouldn't get the help. Because I think he does need it. Clearly. How could you say not? And if you say, well, it's just public intoxication, what's the big deal? In its own little bubble, yeah, what's the big deal? Somebody got fucking drunk. Who cares? Isn't this the same guy who got arrested, what was it, last year for driving while intoxicated? Isn't this the same guy that got popped off way back, what was it, 2009? With all the Vicodin and Somas and drug paraphernalia and cocaine residue in his house. The small amount of steroids. Like, the dude's had a problem. He's had a problem for years. And frankly, I could understand why. I'm sure his body's in a lot of effing pain. All the stuff he's done to his body over the years in his life in professional wrestling. But now we're going to see all the people feeling sorry for him and expressing all this great sympathy for him and be like, hey, we got your back. We're rooting for you. You can do it, Jeff Hardy. And it's like, bullshit. I don't feel sorry for somebody that continues to demonstrate self-destructive behavior. It sucks when they do, and I wish they didn't. But there's only so much of the cup that is full of giveth a fuck about him and giveth a fucketh about it. It's like back there, you look on the wall, Jake the Snake Roberts, for years and years, talking about his battle and talking about his demons and all the different vices and crap. You know what? At some point in time, the sympathy runs out. Eventually, Jake the Snake Roberts got over himself. Eventually, Jake the Snake Roberts truly finally decided, with the help of DDP and others, to get his head out of his own ass and do something before it was too damn late. And I'm very happy that he did. But the reality is that all types of people battle all types of addiction. And we can't just sit there and feel sorry for every fucking buddy, because at some point in time, it's kind of sad and pathetic. And what Jeff Hardy's doing here, like I said, in an isolated bubble, public intoxication, not a big deal. But dude, you've had your issues in the past. And it's not just about you anymore, Jeff. You got a wife, Beth. You got two kids. That should be the most important thing in your damn life. But apparently, being an idiot and causing yourself and the others around you damage is what you prioritize. There's something truly fucked up about that. It is the height of stupidity and, even worse, selfishness. That's what it is, period. When you got others that are depending upon you, when you've got others that rely upon you, to do something like that shows how selfish you really are and shows how little you really truly care about others. Those that probably look to you and love you like it's everything in their life. But you can't show them enough courtesy to love them enough back where you don't do stupid crap like this. I don't want to hear the excuses. You got demons. You got battles. We all got our issues. Plenty of people have addictions. I've been smoking for almost 20 fucking years. I sit there and croak one day due to something related to smoking. I don't want anybody to feel fucking sorry for me, nor should they, because ultimately I'm the idiot that didn't step up and say, you know what, enough of this shit, it's time to stop. It's not the manufacturer's fault, it's not the nicotine's addictive qualities' fault, it is nobody else's fault but mine and mine alone. Nobody's forcing me to do it. Nobody's forcing Jeff Hardy to use drugs in the past. Nobody's forcing Jeff Hardy to still continue to drink when your life should be about other things than that. If you can't do it wisely, and you can't stay out of trouble when you do it, then that is a good indication that you shouldn't do it. And Jeff Hardy, by God, always been a fan. Wish you nothing but the best. But ding dong, dumb dick, it is time to get your head out of your ass. It is time to sit there and do something about it. Don't sit there and feel sorry for yourself and the people that love you and support you. Don't sit there and feel sorry for you and heap all types of empathy and sympathy upon you because you don't fucking deserve it. Because clearly you're too selfish to fucking care. Do something about it. So that way the next time we see your damn name trending on Twitter, it's something good and something positive that you've done in your life. Instead of the next time worrying about, is this mean that he's fucking dead? I don't know about you, but I'm sure not the only one that's out there. When I saw your name, Jeff Hardy, trending on Twitter today, I thought you might have been fucking dead. This is awfully random on a Saturday for you to be trending for something. And knowing your self-inflicting wounds that you've loved to inflict upon yourself over the years, it wouldn't have surprised me if this time would have been the end of times for you. I implore of you, Jeff, do something about it. If you cannot control yourself, then you have a problem. The substances aren't a problem. People around you aren't a problem. The years of wrestling aren't the problem. Life isn't the problem. You're the problem! Don't want to turn around in 6 months, a year, 2 years from now and be doing some remembering Jeff Hardy video because you fucking croaked because you didn't have enough sense and enough desire and love and care for those around you that you negatively impact in your orbit of stupidity to fix it! It's not a laughing matter. It's not a laughing matter at all. I'm not here to mock it. I'm not here to make fun of it. But clearly, either A, the people around you aren't telling you the shit you need to fucking hear, or B, you don't give a crap anyways. Come on, Jeff, there are millions of people around the world that love you. There are millions of people around the world that would be gutted and devastated if something happened to you. If you don't care about yourself enough to do something about it, think about them. And most importantly of all, think about your wife and your two damn kids and do something! Stop drinking. Stop getting fucking arrested. You're a wealthy man. You're a famous person. Get the fuck over yourself, man!